my play how Charles Stuart's bloodline continues today. His descendants, you find out in the last scene, two will be monarchs, and one could be queen. Soon with Katharina, he would be allied, a Protestant king with a Catholic bride.
Majesty, may I humbly bring...
Oh, where's the king? He was here a minute ago.
Majesty, may I humbly bring the sister of the Portuguese king. My king is honored that you will agree to marry her and share your seed. Your bountiful goodness fills us with your compliments, Majesty, from our Portuguese shore. Three kingdoms you rule with masterful skill.
Oh, the ambassador's flattery was more overkill.
Enough of your praises. Bring in my bride.
Majesty.
My dear, would you like a goblet of ale?
The poor princess turned very pale.
Desculpa, eu não falo inglês. Você é Carlos e fala português.
Seeing the king in a vulnerable state, she knew exactly the move she would make. Nell's son, his status mattered to her. Ooh, extreme were actions. His future, her spur. Fetching the sleeping baby from the cradle, she laid the young infant onto the table.
Wake up, my son!
Your father, the king. Your highness, it is your bastard.
Don't you call my son a bastard now.
Bastard met his end. Shall I let go?
No, Nell, don't.
Let him descend.
No, Nell, don't do that, girl.
Then give him a name, a title, a duke, or an earl. Your other bastards have names, but my poor son, a bastard, remains.
God save my son. He's an earl from today.
Over several years, the stories moved on. The Thames took the life of old Margwin. Drunk on brandy when she fell in. Records show that's how she died.
Have I passed over to the other side? The spirits have got the better of me. 'Tis death, methinks. Not rough brandy.
Welcome, ma'am. Pray, sit you down.
I must be dead. Look at me gown.
Next to die was Charles in bed. Apoplexy, so the papers said. Due to the circumstances, they were vague. In fact, he had venereal plague. He sent a last message to his wife to say he loved her all his life. As a final wish, he begged his brother, look after, please, Lord Burford's mother. His brother James, who would take the throne, had a final message of his own. I beg you, Charles, hear my petition to go to heaven, change your religion. And so it was, on the king's deathbed, a final Catholic mass was said. Just 2 years on, not past her prime, Nell's life cut short before her time. Bad blood, they said. Oh, wasn't true.
The great pox got her. Just like you.
Portuguese bagpipes. And so long since we've heard the Majesty.
That, my dear Francis, is as it should be. 2 years of mourning for the King. Our lives have had a solemnly. One constellation through that time, the King's soul in heaven, how sublime. He changed his faith. Confessed his sin.
Ah, yes. Just enough to get him in.
Legacy, you ask it of me. The most fertile king you ever did see. 13 children.
But none of them mine. In a long and illegitimate time.
7 were boys and 6 were girls. All of them are noble to ladies, dukes, and earls. And most famously, I'm happy to say that the Princes William and Harry are with you today. The mother Diana carried my genes through the Duchess of Portsmouth, not through my queen. And Prince William, you know, will one day be the king. And the baby, Prince George, he's one of them who will bring my fine steward lineage back to the throne.
Yet we have no children of our own.
We also share genes with the Duchess Camilla.
Prince Charles, yet another royal lady killer.
One day, Camilla, she might be the queen.
Their blood can be classed as royal Stuart blue.
Oh, I marvel to think my genes so inbred.
There were so many women he took to his bed.
Here's another one-time orange seller.
Hello, Duchess, you old squintbells. Talking of genes, you can add this to your list, since the Earl of Burford still does exist.
But I have something to add. I'm one of the women that he never had. He loved my virtue, which he said stirred his loins. That's when he put me on all of his coins. You've been telling lies. You're not a playwright. You are not that wise. Rule Britannia, and long may she reign. I'm the real playwright. I'm Carolyn Kane.